I was doing some tidying this week, and in the end, I had a design challenge. I'd organized everything nicely, but I didn't have anywhere to put these binder clips. So, the solution I came up with was do a little bit of measuring, and 3D print a box to hold them. I want to walk you through the process of how I made my box for the binder clips. It was relatively easy. So, let's pull this thing up here. So I'm using a piece of software called TinkerCAD, and TinkerCAD is a really beginner, user-friendly way of doing sort of 3D design. I find it user-friendly, but students really get frustrated by it because it kind of limits you to your shapes. So let's hit this. I'm going to hit Tinker this, and we'll take a look. So the thing that TinkerCAD does is that it allows you sort of to play around with shapes on a 3D plane. You start off with your grid on the base, and if I were to delete this, then that shows you sort of the overall shape. If I right click, I can move around the grid, and if I use the mouse wheel, I can zoom in and zoom out. So I'm going to just Control Z and undo my box deletion, and this shows you the box right here. So to create this box, it was really simple, and I'm going to walk backwards. So step one is to create a box. Cool. I already knew what my dimensions were going to be. I decided I wanted it 4 inches by, I think I said 6 inches. So first off, you need to make sure your grid is in inches. So you can edit that by hitting this edit button, and you make sure it's in inches. Okay, great. I'm going to cancel that. So now that my grid is in inches, I can play around. So if I grab the corner, it allows me to shrink and resize, which is good. But it only lets me do it on the X and Y plane. So first off, I get to my original, I guess I'm looking at this. This is almost 6 inches. There we go, 6 inches. And that's good. Now I can move down this way and make it 4 inches. So I went too big, sorry, backwards. 4 inches. Great. And if I want to raise it taller, I need to grab this one here. So I think I decided to make it like 2 inches tall. Might have gone higher. I might have actually made it 3 or 4 inches. So let's pretend it's 3 inches. So now I have a box. It's 3 inches tall. It's 6 inches across, and it's 4 inches the opposite direction. Just so you can see, there's my grid. Lovely. And you can play around with this. This allows me to rotate it. This allows me to rotate it in this direction. This allows me to raise it in the air, all those kinds of things. So it just, the cool thing about TinkerCAD is that it says, okay, here you go. You can work in these shapes. You can make rounded things. You can make triangular things. You can make cylinders. You can do all wedges. You can do text. Any of these shapes are free for you to use, and you can play around with them. I know some students really want to try to make 20-sided dice using this, but that's not what we're here for today. Here today, we're just trying to make a really simple, really usable box. So these are solid shapes, and these are not solid shapes. These are kind of like cutouts. So I can create a cutout box of similar dimensions to my previous box. So this was 4x6. So let's make this almost 6 inches. Let's make it 5 3/4 inches this way, and then let's make it stretch it out this way to be almost 4 inches, so 3 3/4 inches. Great. And then let's raise it up and make it, I mean, I could go the full 3 inches because I can raise it just by pulling this thing. So if you see, I'm gonna go back, take a step back. That was tricky. So right now it's resting on the ground, and I don't want it to rest on the ground, because if I insert this into here and then I remove it from my box, then it's going to make a hole that goes all the way through. So I won't have a box so much as I will have a tube. So if I pull this, I raise it up just slightly. Cool. So it should not go all the way through my box. And so this is now a hole inside my square box shaped thing, and it's going to have an opening. So just to show you what that's going to look like, if I grab everything, so once again, I'm going to left click, I'm going to pull over, and I'm going to circle everything. And then I group it, boom, it has now grouped them together. It has created, it's merged them, it's flattened them, and created a box. This box is 4 inches across, 6 inches this way. It's got 1/4 inch thickness on this side and this side, I believe, and same over here. And then the bottom is raised up. So that is now a thing that I could do anything with. I can keep this design. I could write my name on it. I can decorate it. I can do all kinds of things. I could just grab this text thing and add some text and put it on the side. I can add a dome. There's a lot I can do with these simple shapes if I decided to. But right now, I just wanted to create this box because this was my first ever try, and I wanted to see what would happen if I 3D printed it. So to go from this file into something I can 3D print, all I have to do is go to export, and I hit STL. And if I export it as an STL file, I can then take that over to the 3D printing software, slice it up, and 3D print it. I could do the same thing with an OBG file as well, but STL is just what I've been going with, and it seems to be working okay. Thanks to careful measuring, my box was a perfect fit for all my binder clips, and it fits beautifully in the drawer. I'm pretty happy with the result. TinkerCAD is really, really simple. It's really, really easy to play around with. A lot of people use this in elementary school. So if you are struggling with this, just have some patience and think about it and be like, okay, what would a grade 4 student do here? And the trick is just to not get stressed out. It's to like make mistakes and hit Control Z to undo those mistakes and try again. There's a lot of cool things you can do with TinkerCAD. This is just like one thing. It's the easiest. You can make your things out of Minecraft blocks if you want. You can make them out of Lego. It's an interesting way to visualize what you're doing. But it's easy. It's browser-based, which I really like, so that I can use this at school without having to install any software. And it's generally very user-friendly. So just wanted to kind of show you what's available and show you that it's out there.